Welcome to the Airlift Workshop, where you get expertise from the air suspension specialists, keeping you on the road and in top condition. Today, we're installing an Airlift 1000HD kit on a 2019 Ram 1500. Remember, this overview doesn't replace your installation guide. Grab yours out of the box and let's get started. First, mark the upper and lower springs and spring seats with a tire marker to note its location. Remove the lower shock bolts from both shocks, as well as the brake line holder bolt from the Panhard bracket located behind the passenger side coil spring. Save this bolt for reuse. Then, pull the line holder away from the bracket. Next, raise the truck and support the frame with safety stands. For filming purposes, we're using a drive-on vehicle hoist. Drop the axle low enough so that the coil springs can be removed. With the spring removed, remove and discard the spring rubber isolator from the middle of the coil spring. The isolator at the top does not need to be removed. Cut the airline in two equal lengths and install the straight pump connector and airline clamp on one end of each airline. Remove the valve cap from the air spring and screw the pump connector on the stem finger tight. Slide an air spring protector over each hose and onto the top of the air spring. Insert the air spring assembly into the top of the stock coil spring and push to the bottom. Set the rubber upper spring seat on the top of the spring assembly, making sure the end of the coil spring is positioned correctly in the mount. The end of the coil spring indexes into the mount only one way. Insert the hose through the hole in the upper spring seat mount and reinstall the coil spring assembly. Make sure to align the marks previously drawn onto the upper and lower springs and spring seats. Raise the axle just enough to seat the coil spring into the upper and lower mounts, making sure the tabs fit into the upper spring seat. With the spring seated, push the protector up inside the upper rubber spring seat as far as possible. Repeat assembly for the other side. With both springs in position, raise the axle fully and reattach the lower shock bolts. Reattach the passenger side brake line bracket and bolt and tighten securely. Remove the safety stands. Before routing airlines to the air springs, note the available length and pick a convenient inflation valve drilling location. We'll use the license plate recess as our location. You could also use the wheel well flanges or under the gas cap access door. You may need to drill a hole. Next, determine if you will be using single path or dual path airline routing. Single path airline installation is recommended for vehicles that typically have even weight distribution. If the weight in the vehicle will vary from side to side with unequal pressures that will need leveling, use a dual path installation. For dual path installations, eliminate the T-fitting and route separate airlines for both air springs. For single path installations, choose a location for the T-fitting on the wheel well, license plate, or rear bumper. Determine and cut adequate length of airline to reach the T from the left and right side air springs. To connect airlines, first slide the airline clamp onto the airline. Push the airline assembly over the barbed stem so that all barbs are covered. Compress the ears on the airline clamp using pliers and slide it forward to fully cover the barbs. When cutting airlines, never cut from the side or with wire cutters. You'll leave a jagged edge and ruin the hose. Instead, use a sharp razor blade to get a square, clean cut. A hose cutter will also do the trick. Place a nut and star washer on the inflation valve and push it through the inflation valve hole. Use a rubber washer, flat washer, and nut to secure it in place. Then twist on the valve cap. Before getting on the road, inflate the air springs to 30 psi and spray all airline connections with a soapy solution to check for leaks. Remember, when using Airlift 1000HD air springs, you must add air pressure to the springs before adding a load to the vehicle. That does it. Remember, you can find more information about all of our products at airliftcompany.com, and our knowledgeable customer service team is always just a phone call away. Thanks for joining us in the Airlift Workshop.